Hi everyone, welcome to this Getting Started tutorial for the Syncfusion React Rich Text Editor component. The React Rich Text Editor comes with an efficient user interface so that you can have a good editing experience and mobile support. You can edit and format the HTML markup or markdown content using a variety of tools like lists, images, links, and tables with modular architecture. Now, I am going to create my project with the help of the Create React App toolchain, which installs the latest version of React and React DOME and React scripts. I will view and edit my code using Visual Studio Code and view the output on one of the supported browsers. To create a new React project, I need to install Create React App globally on my machine using the command npm install -g create React App. As I have already installed it, I am skipping this step here. Now, let me create a new React project using the command create React App project name. I want to create a React App with TypeScript, so let me add --template TypeScript to the existing command. And I named my project React-RTE. This will create an empty React application with no Syncfusion packages. I will navigate to the newly created application folder. To start using the rich text editor component within this empty application, I install the Syncfusion React Rich Text Editor package and its subcomponent packages using the command npm install -ej2-react-rich-text-editor --save. Once the installation is complete, my application is ready. The first thing I need to do here is open the app.tsx file and import the Rich Text Editor component from the ej2-react-rich-text-editor package. Next, I will replace the default code and add the React Rich Text Editor component within the render method of the React component. Next, I open the index.tsx file and import register license from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Then, I register the Syncfusion React trial license key by using the register license method. The Syncfusion React license key registration is required from the 2022 Volume 1 release onward. Next, I define the CSS for the Rich Text Editor. I can either import the React Rich Text Editor component CSS in the app.css file or reference the CDN link in the index.html file. To make it simple, I choose the second option. So, let me open the index.html file and reference the CDN link inside the head section, which includes the combined CSS references of all the essential JS2 React components. For this rich text editor component, I am going to define the HTML element paragraph and add contents for it. By default, the rich text editor will render a toolbar, so here I will import and inject the toolbar, link, image, and HTML editor module from the EJ2 React Rich Text Editor package. To inject these modules, I have imported the inject module from the same package. Now, I save this application and run it using the command npm start. When you look at the rich text editor, you can see the HTML content and default toolbar items. If I want to customize the toolbar, then I can make use of the toolbar settings property. I want to show only 4 items in the toolbar. So, first, I define an object variable called custom toolbar settings with the required toolbar items. I added bold, italic, undo, and redo toolbar items in this items array. Now, I assign this object variable to the toolbar settings property. I also make sure that the toolbar module is imported and injected in the services property. So now, looking at the rich text editor component, the toolbar is displayed with the custom items, bold, italic, undo, and redo. Next, I will show you how to add 3 HTML elements in the toolbar: table, image, and link. First, I am going to add the table element. I add the item create table within this custom toolbar settings object. To add and work with the table option, I import the table module and inject this module here. Looking at the rich text editor component, the table button has been added to the toolbar. If I click the table button, I can select the rows and columns in the built-in UI. I can also enter the number of rows and columns in this dialog by clicking the Insert Table option. By default, there will be 3 rows and columns in a numeric text box. Next, I will show you how to include an image HTML element in the Rich Text Editor toolbar. I add the item image within this custom toolbar settings object. I make sure that the image module is imported and inject this module here. You can see the Rich Text Editor toolbar displayed with an image button. I click it and the Insert Image dialog opens. In this dialog, you can find 2 options to upload an image. The first option is uploading an image through a browse button. The second is putting an image link in this field. I click this browse button and upload an image. Notice here, the image is rendered in the component. To add the same image using an HTML image tag, I define the image tag with a source attribute within the React Rich Text Editor code. As I am going to refer the image path from public folder in the React app, so I add the source path like this. Then, I set a custom height and width for the image. You can see the Rich Text Editor component displays the provided image. Next, I am going to show you how to enable the link option in the toolbar. First, I add the item create link within this custom toolbar settings object and make sure that the link module is imported and injected here. Second, I import the Quick Toolbar module and include it within this services property to show the Quick Inline Toolbar option. Looking at the component, the link button was added to the toolbar. I select the text-rich text editor and click the link button. The Insert Link dialog opens, showing options. In the web address field, I add a Syncfusion React RTE user guide link and a title UG documentation page so that, while hovering over the display text, the title will be shown in a tooltip. The display text field shows the default value rich text editor as I select that text. Notice that a checkbox option is provided to open the link in a new window. I click the text and the quick inline toolbar opens to show the open link, edit link, and remove link. I click open link so that the UG page opens in a new window like this. Suppose I want to add this hyperlink through an HTML element. I define an anchor tag with the attribute hyperlink and set the appropriate link for it. Look at the output page now. The rich text editor text is shown as a link. Next, I will show you how to retrieve formatted content from the rich text editor through a button click. To add a button, I install the button package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2react-buttons-save. As I have already installed the Syncfusion React Buttons package in my app, I am skipping this step here. Next, I import the button component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Buttons package. I add a button component within this division element and set its text as get.html. I then define the onClick event for this button and add the relevant handler. Next, I need to access the Rich Text Editor component instance, so I define a not null variable of type Rich Text Editor component. Then, I add a reference variable using a ref attribute within the Rich Text Editor code. To get the Rich Text Editor contents, I define a string variable named RTE value and assign this public method get.html. And now, you can see the Rich Text Editor component rendered with a button component. When I click the get.html button, the formatted content is retrieved in this variable. In this video, we have seen how to create a React app and add the Syncfusion React Rich Text Editor component to it. We have seen how to edit and format HTML content and use a few of the important features of the Rich Text Editor. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire React suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.